come onto this swamp when we first come onto it down back down here. There was more pigs coming out of the creek that's over the back here. They just looked like they were wallowing up and coming out to feed, but there was a little young boar in there, but he didn't have any ivory, or he wasn't mature, so I know there's two good shooter boars, but they're not here at the moment. But we're going to work our way up on the top of this ridge up here, and there's a couple of other swamps up there, and see if they're up there. If not, we'll come back later on in an arvo or something and see if we can get them. This boar that just got onto here, spotted him up the end of the swamp up here, but the wind was sort of a bit wrong and a few mob pigs there got a bit of scent of us, so we cut up above this basalt rocky wall up around this ridge here to get the wind right. We've come in and got back onto him, and yeah, he's still here out feeding. Anyway, we get in and there was a few pigs to our right, a few to our left, and yeah, he was sort of moving back and forth, in and out of the swamp. And he got into range once, and he sort of didn't give me the shot, and he moved off. You know, he just kept up in the shadows here, and moved in and stayed tight to some saplings. And he was fully underwater, eh? And then, yeah, got into these trees and he sort of come out and 15 yards and whop. Hit him sort of, yeah, high lungs there. Arrows locked up on the other side of the shoulder and yeah, no, he's gone 60 yards up here. Nah, pretty sweet.
We've done a bit of a lap around that swamp. A little bit of sign, not a heap, but with probably about, I don't know, maybe 40 minutes of light left, we're going to quickly head back to the quads and then go to another swamp. Yeah, hopefully we can get there before dark, but I don't like our chances. Anyway, so here we go. Just stay back there. Although if I did, I wouldn't have a shot, so. It was quarter to nine, I just.
I was sort of humming and hawing, but when I'm doing that, I'm just better off not. Just not shooting. So. I don't know. I couldn't believe that just happened. I was literally just doing it. I just missed an opportunity just then, like seriously 10-15 yards at a hog. I was just doing the interview then, or the talk of what just happened, and another boar just come running out. Looked like a different boar, even bigger boar. And he come in there, he stopped about 15-20 yards, slightly broadside. I just let it out just about to shoot, and then he sort of done a bit of a spin, ran through the bush here and stopped exactly where the other boar was at about 15 yards, and I'm pretty sure I just pumped him and he just ran through there and just fallen over. Well,
We sort of come in, got about 80 yards, and this is where he's piled up. I sort of heard him crashing, so I was pretty confident. But the arrow sort of, the way he was angling to me, sort of hit him right at the point of shoulder there and sort of come out about that far back on the other side. Yeah, he's an absolute lump of a hog. I haven't shot many pigs bigger than this. But he's nice and clean, obviously been in the, just coming out of the water. So look, the mozzies are absolutely hammering, so we're going to come back in the morning and give us a bit better of a look at him. But yeah, absolutely stoked the way it panned out. Unbelievable.
To the next spot, and it's pretty promising straight up. Look at the older boar, it's bedded on the bank, and the younger boar's feeding out in the swamp now, so once he gets a little bit further, we're gonna make him move.
Mozzie Boss, the joys of Cape York.
I should be a foot model. We started making our way out there, but he's starting to move down the swamp now a little bit. So he's just sort of making his way down, rubbing every tree he can. I think we're going to cut down here to get the wind a little bit better. Maybe cut around the bottom of the swamp. Hopefully cut him off. Got this other young one out here behind us. He's went back into the bush. Trotted back up and then come back out a little bit further. So we're going to let him go anyway. He's only young anyway. He's not really mature. So this one here is a different story though. He's back out there. Just made our way to this swamp. Straight up was one of the saddleback boys. The wind's a little bit average for him. He's sort of laying his back down there. Wind's sort of cutting back that way, so don't think he's going to really reposition him anytime soon. He's tolerating an ibis stand on at the moment. That one's changed back here too. It's all right, we'll just sit here a little bit. Yeah, can't think of a bit of a game plan.
When the wind's really blowing consistent, usually it's coming from that way.
Yeah, all right, tell me about it. That wind. Oh my god. We're so lucky then. So lucky. He didn't pin us then. But he I don't know what he heard, or he knew something wasn't right. But like, we're literally like 6 yards. The only thing I was worried about is drawing back with me back on. Like, it was like dead still. Absolutely dead still.
We had to just cut that short. We were just doing our talk then. I just noticed over the back of Brad's shoulder, the pig come straight back to water again. It done a big, I don't know, maybe like a 30-yard dash around and then come straight back onto the game trail we sort of come in on and then went straight into the water and then sort of just turned around and then that's where he lay. Like, I just can't believe he just come back to water, just like literally like 40, 50 yards away. So it had me sort of worried there for a bit. I was pretty confident with the shot, but I don't know, just sort of makes you second guess yourself when he comes straight back around to where it was, and honestly I thought he would have died straight up there, but it would have been like maybe like 30 seconds. So, and I honestly wouldn't put that arrow anywhere else. So, anyway, he's down and yeah, we'll go check him out.